Dag allemaal, we zijn terechtgekomen bij de letter Nun. Na, 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 na. The letter Nun is a very flowy letter. It's a letter of water. It's a letter that corresponds to the sense of smell. So, the letter Nun by the Book of Creation is corresponding to the element of water. And like you know, every organ in the body has attachment to a certain letter. So before we're going to practice the Nun, we're going to talk it out. So when we talk the Nun, like try to feel it in your body. Hold your hands on your belly button, around the belly button, and just feel the N, N, Na, 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 N, Ni, Ni. You can feel that the Nun, that the letter Nun, goes very deep. That's why the letter Nun by the Sefer Yetzirah is related to intestine. So this place in our body is the Dharman. So how do the Dharman connect to the sense of smell? Because it says in the Book of Creation, Himlich ot Nun bereach. He made the letter Nun king over smell. So what's the connection between the letter Nun to the intestine? So let's take a pause for a minute from the intestine and talk about the letter Nun. The letter Nun is the sense of smell, which is the highest sense that is attached to our neshama, to our soul. So if we think about the word neshama, which is soul, it starts with the letter Nun. Also neshima, which is breathing, also starts with the letter Nun. So neshima and neshama, they are the same word. It only has one difference of the yud. Why? Because when Hashem, when God wanted to give life to man, he just breathed. He took a breath of his and he put it through the nose into his body. That's how the neshama got in the body, through Hashem's breath. So let's wrap it. And what is the connection between the sense of smell to our intestine? So as you all know, I'm dealing with Chinese acupuncture, and in my clinic I keep on advising people to go for cleansing and to clean their intestine, because the intestine is the center of our whole body. Whenever we have like a problem in our bowel movement or in the intestine, something is stuck, poisons are stuck in the edges of our intestine, our sense of smell, whether you notice it or not, is a little bit changing. Because when our intestine is clean and when we feel clean and rejuvenate, our sense of smell is much deeper. Like the letter Nun, it's a deep letter, it goes deep in. All this area of our lower belly around the belly button is an area of water. We have the womb over there, we have the intestine over there, we have water flowing when a baby is coming out. This is the area of water. Also, when we have cleansing and we drink a lot of water, so we're cleaning this area, we're cleaning the intestine. So as much as this area holds water, and the bladder is also sitting in this area, which holds a lot of water, I want to show you what's behind the bladder, which is the kidney. Through the kidney, we clean the body and we clean the toxic of our body. And how do we do that? Through drinking water, through flowing water into our body, into our system. The letter Nun is actually putting our hands alongside the body, facing up a little bit, and our legs are actually, our tippy toes are actually going a little bit up. In this pose, we're going to inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. When you're lifting up your tippy toes, you're actually leaning a little bit backwards, and you can sense and feel more the muscles in your lower belly. So you can inhale again and exhale through the mouth. Push it deeper and deeper, you're exhaling into the lower part of your belly. For the gevorderden, I'm gonna advise to do the same pose with closing the mula bandha, inhaling with all this area closed in, And exhaling, letting go. So as we said, the Nun is a very deep letter. And if we put the letter Nun at the end of a word, we have long Nun. It's called Langer Nun or Nun Sufit. It sounds different. It does have the same deepening, like my son, Eden, with a longer Nun at the end. I'm going to show you how we practice the longer Nun. I'm going to take a deep inhale, lift our hands up. Try to lift your hands and point your fingers towards the front, like that. And stand up on our tippy toes. And if you can't stand long enough in this pose, you can just start walking. On your tippy toes. That's very long. And now, for the vergevorderden, I'm going to show you another way to do the Nun, which is fun and very, very healthy. And come with me. Okay, that was the Nun. Tot de volgende keer. Doei!